Hey guys, I'm Gavin. Matt and I have played a lot of crazy games over the years. Here's one of our favorites.
What's up, CCB kids? I'm Matt. This is Gavin, the greatest guy I know.
Oh, thanks.
And today, Gavin, why don't you tell us what our challenge is?
Well, you guys know the game of horse, right? We're gonna do a special basketball challenge. But this is gonna be veggie edition.
Veggie edition.
Which means you basketball fans, you know what the game of course is. Someone shoots, and the other person tries to make that shot if that first person makes it.
Yep.
And if they don't, then you get a letter.
I usually don't. I'm not very good at basketball. But I'm gonna try my best at this.
Yeah. Maybe today will be different, because we're not using basketballs.
Mm-mm.
We're using vegetables.
Vegetables.
So instead of riding horse, we're actually gonna be doing veggies as the letters.
That's
and we're
right.
actually, we're gonna have a white shirt on and we're gonna write the letters of veggies on our shirts.
So that's right. Can you spell veggie? V-E-G-G. 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 We'll figure it out.
Cool.
Let's do this.
Hopefully one of us will actually make this. Okay, there we go. Vegetable. Onion from 2 feet away. Just like I'm the king on the microphone. So it's Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunks. Favorite play is the alley. I like the pick and I like the give and go. Vegetable. All right, Matt. Beat this. Another G. Getting close, man.
Yeah, it's a really close game today.
Yeah, it's pretty close.
Super, super close.
The onion shot from one knee, right here.
I've been doing really great so far. So, you
know. All right. I think there is an eye about to appear. Boom. Right there. One more letter.
You know, at least it's a close game.
Okay.
And it stayed.
Okay. Extra points. Do it. On the scene, and Ralph Simpson is really mean. Bill Russell didn't take no jump, and Dal Dawkins got a monster.
Alrighty.
Do you know how to spell veggie?
Maybe.
Cool. Here I go. Cool.
Yeah. Off the backboard. Can't check.
Alright, well, here we go.
Alright, let's see if I can draw a G that doesn't.
Oh, yeah,
it looks a little better than. Yeah,
okay. Onion, no look.
Oh! Dude! Oh.
Did I make it?
Yes!
Oh, okay. Alright,
no look.
That's what you might expect from me.
Yes!
Veggie, you were a veggie.
Well, at least I had a little bit of a comeback. It wasn't the worst thing ever, but it was pretty bad.
Great job, though. That was fun.
Yeah! Well, congratulations, Gavin. You did it. You beat me at veggie. You know, you're just really, really great at vegetable.
Yep, the vegetable champion right here.
Well done. Well done.
Vegetables as basketballs, pretty fun. When I'm not using veggies to play games, I actually don't mind eating my veggies. But in today's Bible story, Daniel and his friends ate nothing but veggies. You see, the nation of Israel had not been following God, and it got them into trouble. Eventually, the nation of Babylon conquered them, and the Jewish people were taken into exile. They had to leave their home and live far away in Babylon. Once they got there, many young men were tested to see if they could work for the king. During these tests, all of them were offered food from the king, food that God had said the Jewish people shouldn't eat. Daniel asked if he and his friends could eat only vegetables instead. The Babylonian charge thought that this was a bad idea, but he let them do it anyway. After 10 days, Daniel and his friends were healthier and stronger than the rest of the men who ate the king's food. And later on, they were brought before the king himself. Here's what the Bible says happens next in Daniel chapter 1, verses 19 and 20. The king talked with them, and he found none equal to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So they entered the king's service. In every matter of wisdom and understanding about which the king questioned them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and enchanters in his whole kingdom. So Daniel and his friends stayed loyal to God, and it paid off big time. They had tremendous favor with the king, who gave them each very important jobs after that. And all they did was trust God and eat veggies. What if you had to eat one kind of vegetable every day for the rest of your life? Which one would you pick? I'd probably pick lettuce, since I like a good salad. What about you? Talk about that in your groups for a few minutes, then we'll get our Bible breakdown with Matt.
Thank you.
If I had to eat one vegetable every day for the rest of my life, I would eat avocado, which is actually not a veggie, but a fruit, so I'm kind of cheating. But who really treats avocado like fruit? Answer, no one. Would you eat avocado in a fruit salad? I think not. You would eat avocado with other veggies, or turn it into that simply magical and tasty dip, guacamole. What? You can put other fruits in guacamole if you like that sort of thing, things like cranberries or pineapple, but most fruits are sweet and avocado is not sweet. But avocado on its own just doesn't cut it as a fruit, so I'm treating it like a veggie. Also, now I can't stop thinking about eating guacamole. What were we talking about? Veggies, that's right. Okay, I'll just be fair and pick asparagus. If it's roasted or grilled, it can taste pretty good. Plus, it has a fun side effect. Ask your parents. I wonder if Daniel ate asparagus. Maybe he ate asparagus with guacamole. Asparaguac. Either way, in our Bible story, we learned that Daniel and his friends had a tough choice to make. I bet the king of Babylon had some pretty tasty food for all those guys. It must have been tough to say no to all of it. But they had to be brave and obey God, even if it meant eating veggies only. When I was your age, I used to go to a friend's house after school until my mom was done with work. While I was there, my mom only had one rule: don't eat any sugar. You can have fruit or nuts or even veggies as a snack, but nothing with sugar. No cookies, no candy, nothing like that. Maybe some of your parents are the same way. Truth is, sugar did make me a little crazy as a kid. I know my mom was trying to help me be healthy, but my friend's mom didn't have the same rule. So every day, I would eat an apple or banana or cashews, and he would have cookies, candy, or cupcakes. It wasn't fair. Sometimes I really wanted to disobey my mom. She wasn't around. My friend wouldn't tell on me. But I knew it wasn't right. Disobeying your parents is disobeying God. I had to trust my mom, and that showed I trusted God. And every once in a while, if I had obeyed, my mom would surprise me with a giant serving of ice cream, my favorite sugary treat. Sometimes you want to be in charge and eat whatever or do whatever you want. But if you're brave, trust God, and do what's right, you will be rewarded. Not always in the way you think, but life will be better for you. So, keep trusting God. Be brave.